Dear students, today in this video lecture we are going to discuss about the calculation of mode when mode is ill-defined in a continuous series through Sugan Economics. Dear students, today I am going to explain about how to calculate mode when mode is ill-defined. Here, when mode is ill-defined means it's not possible for us to calculate mode for the given series. So at that time, how we can calculate mode? Right? In the previous video lecture, I have explained about calculation of mode by empirical formula, but if the values of median and mean are given. But here, I am going to explain about today, for a continuous series, if mode is ill-defined, and how we can calculate mode. Okay, so now I will take an example. So here marks, it should be taken as x, and number of students it should be taken as f. Okay, so under marks you can write 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, and 60 to 70, 60 to 70. And now the frequencies are, so here you take 3, 8, 12, 17, 22, 28, 32. Okay, so here these are all the frequencies and these are all the marks values. So here you can go through the frequency value. The highest frequency lies in the last class. When the highest frequency lies in the last or the first class, it's not possible for us to calculate mode. Okay, so now how we can calculate mode for this particular series, today I am going to explain. Listen carefully, right? So here first, for the calculation of, so here if mode is ill-defined, what we have to do means, for that sum first we have to calculate mean and median, then with the help of mean and median only it's possible for us to calculate mode by using empirical formula. So suppose now what we have to do means, first we have to calculate the table values for mean and median. So here you take midpoints, and it should be denoted by M. So here the midpoints are 5, 15, 25, 35, 45, 55, and 65. So after calculating the midpoints, what we have to do means, we have to assume any one of the midpoint as our assumed mean value. So now I have assumed 35 as our assumed mean. So now what we have to do means, we have to calculate d dash value. So here I am doing the calculation with the help of step deviation method. So now you have to calculate d dash. So d dash is nothing but M minus A by C. So here that is equal to M minus 35 divided by C equal to 10. M minus 35 divided by 10. So here what value you are taking as the assumed mean, for that you can put 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, and the values which are below the assumed mean value, take plus 1, 2, 3. So these are the d dash values. So now after calculating d dash value, what we have to do means we have to calculate f d dash value. F d dash value. So f into d dash. So this is d dash value and this is f value. So here 3 into 3 is 9, minus 9, minus 9. So here minus 16. So here minus 12. So here 0. Here 22. So here 56. So here 96. Right? So now you take the positive values separately, the total of positive values separately, and the total of negative values separately, and find out sigma fd dash. So here the positive total are 6, 12, 14, 4, 10, 17, 174. And the negative value total are 15, 17, 7, 3, 37. So 37 is the negative and 174 is the positive value. Now you take the difference between these two things, that is equal to sigma f d dash. So sigma f d dash equal to 7, 3, 1. 137 is your sigma fd dash value. So this is the table for calculating mean value. Then we have to calculate one more value for calculating median, that is cumulative frequency. We have to find out cumulative frequencies. The cumulative frequencies are, so here you put first frequency 3, 8, 11. So here 23, 23, 30, 40, then here 62, then here 62, 90, and here 122. So our n value is equal to 122. So 10, 19, 29, 32, 6, 10, 2. Okay, 122. So now we have calculated all the values which we need to calculate mean and median. Then after calculating mean and median, we have to find out the model value applying empirical formula. So first we will calculate mean. Calculate mean. So here the formula is x bar equal to a plus sigma f d dash divided by n into c. N into c. So now you can substitute the values. What is your a value? A equal to 35. So 35 plus sigma f d dash is equal to 137, and your n value is equal to 122. 122, and the class limit or class interval is equal to 10. So now here that is equal to 35 plus 1370 divided by 122. So now we have to calculate 1370 should be divided by 122. So 1 time 22, 5, 1, 0, point, sorry, 0, 50, then again 1, 122, then 8, 28, put 0, point, 2 times, then 6, 4, you put here 3 times. Okay, so here the value that is equal to 35 plus 11.23. So here x bar equal to 46.23 marks. So we have calculated the arithmetic mean value. The arithmetic mean value is equal to 46.23. So now we have to calculate median. So now median. So here median equal to size of n by 2th item. So that is equal to size of 122 divided by 2th item. So here median equal to 61th item. 61st item, 61st item. So here after calculating the median size, now we have to identify where this median size comes under the cumulative frequency. So here the median size comes under 62. So now we have to locate the median class. So the median class is 40 to 50 is our median class. So now you can write the formula for calculating median. So here the formula is median equal to L plus N by 2 minus CF divided by F into C. So now you can substitute the values. So that is equal to, what is L? L equal to 40 plus N by 2 equal to 61. Minus cumulative frequency. So here the cumulative frequency is, this is CF 40. So here L equal to 40. Right? So CF equal to 40. CF is also equal to 40. And the frequency is equal to, so here the frequency is equal to 22. Into 10. So here that is equal to, so here you write 40 plus, so here in the numerator 61 minus 40, that is equal to 21. 21 should be multiplied with 10, so 210 divided by 22. So now that is equal to, 40 plus. So now we can divide 210 by 22. So 210 divided by 22. So here you take 9.54. So here the division value of 210 by 22, that is equal to 9.54. So here median equal to 49.54. So we have calculated mean value and also we have calculated the median value. So mean is equal to 46.23 and median is equal to 49.54. Now we have to calculate mode here. Mode is ill defined for this particular series because here the frequency, highest frequency is 32. So 32 comes under the last class. So it means here this is F1 value and this is F0 value. We are not having F2 value. So that we are telling mean is ill defined for this particular series. So now we have to apply the empirical formula to find out mode. So now we have to calculate mode. So mode equal to, so when mode is ill defined, we can apply empirical formula. The empirical formula is mode equal to, that is z equal to 3 median, 3 median minus 2 mean, 3 median minus 2 mean. This is the formula for calculating mode when mode is ill-defined. So already we have calculated the value of median and we have calculated the value of mean. So now here you take that is equal to 3 into median value is 49.54 minus 2 into the mean value is 46.23. So now you take the product of these two things. So the product is equal to 3 multiplied with 49.54, that is equal to 148.62. Okay. So now minus, now you have to multiply 46.23 with 2. 92.46. So now you can take the difference between these two things, that is equal to mode. So now mode equal to, you can take the difference between these two things, that is 148.62 minus 92.46. So this is equal to 56.14. So mode equal to 56.16 marks. So here also we write. Right? So now we have calculated all the three values. So x bar is equal to 46.23 marks and median is equal to 49.54 marks and mode equal to 56.16 marks. So in this manner we can calculate mode when mode is ill-defined. Thank you. Dear students, kindly go through the video carefully and study well. Those who are not subscribing Sugan Economics so far, kindly subscribe and click the bell button. Then only you will get intimation whenever we are uploading the video. Thank you, friends.